73 degrees under glorious, clear, near cloudless skies. What a night for this Copa America quarterfinal in Foxborough. Argentina, the winners of Group D, the only team across all four groups to win all three matches in the first phase. 10 goals scored, just one against. And Venezuela too, unbeaten as runners-up of Group C. An impressive win over Uruguay, their standout. Today is just the Vinotinto's third ever appearance in a Copa America quarter-final. Well, Argentina looking to reach the semis. A team who've won this title, the Copa America title, on 14 prior occasions. Venezuela, the nation who have never won this crown, and the only team from South America never to reach a FIFA World Cup. They are the underdogs here. Just once have Venezuela's Vino Tinto, the Burgundy, beaten Argentina, and that was in a World Cup qualifier around 5 years ago. Lots of fans here wearing the number 10 shirt of Lionel Messi, of course. They've all come to see the world's best, maybe the best ever. How do you tell? But he does start tonight, his first start of this Copa America Centenario. Hence the huge roar when his name was called out here in the stadium around, what, 3 or 4 minutes ago. And these players, the Argentina reserves, to go and sit on the bench. Tonight, Messi is not among their number. Today, from the start. There's down the years some 20 prime meetings, 19 Argentina wins, just one for Venezuela. In terms of goal aggregate, Argentina against Venezuela, 74 goals, an average of almost four a game. Venezuela, just 10 in their 20 matches against the Albiceleste. Well, Venezuela do have a number of fans here, but you'd say the lion's share are here to see and to cheer on Argentina. We had 35,000 or so here to see Brazil knocked out in the last game in Boston. Maybe another even bigger upset tonight if Argentina, with all their star talent, was to be sent crashing out of Copa America Centenario by one of the outsiders, Venezuela. Venezuela, the rock-bottom team in the current World Cup standings too. Just 1 point from their six qualifiers. Argentina have 11. But this is the Copa America Centenario. Knockout football. There must be a winner. And they're back in harness. Back with the armband, the main man, the world's premier player for the nation ranked one in the world, Lionel Messi. And Argentina. And what a day for that young mascot to escort Messi onto the field tonight. Well, here come the two nations' respective national flags. Means the two teams can't be too far behind them. Real sense of anticipation here in Foxborough tonight. An Argentina play, there is always a story, always huge interest across the globe, even more so when their main man is in their team. And that's the case tonight. Conditions here for football could not be better for this quarter-final tie in Copa America Centenario. tonight. There must be a winner if we are level, and the teams have never had a draw. But if there was, at 90 minutes, we would go straight into a penalty shootout. Stage is set. And here come the two teams. 23 years without a trophy. For Argentina, that's a lifetime. They're taggers, serial runners-up they'd love to be rid of. And is this Copa America to be where they do become winners again? The world's number one team, led by the planet's number one player. If you believe the press, today's game a foregone conclusion for Lionel Messi and the Albiceleste. Venezuela, the rank outsiders, only a third ever quarter-final for them, and just one win against Argentina in 20 prior attempts. But Boston is where Brazil were sent packing by Peru, and Venezuela have already seen off 15-time champions Uruguay. A long shot, yes, but as we've seen in this stadium only a few nights ago, shocks can and do happen. Nothing is taken as a given in Copa America Centenario. Argentina led from the front by Lionel Messi. The captain back, fully fit. Venezuela, beware. Well, Messi played in Puerto La Cruz 5 years ago when they did lose to Venezuela by a goal to nil, their only loss ever to the Vino Tinto. That was in World Cup qualification for the Brazil finals. In the Copa America, four prior meetings, all wins by Argentina, and never by less than a three-goal winning buffer. Before the action, time to break off and pause and drink in atmosphere and the two nations' respective anthems. First, you'll hear the anthem of the 14-time winners of Copa America, Argentina.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the national anthem of Argentina.
Damas y caballeros, por favor, ponerse de pie para escuchar el himno nacional de Argentina.
Please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem of Venezuela.
Por favor, mantenerse de pie para escuchar el himno de Venezuela.
Thank you.
What chance, Venezuela, world ranking number 77 against Argentina, world ranking number one, top of the shop. In front of goalkeeper Sergio Romero, Gabriel Mercado and Marcos Rojo return. Facundo Roncaglia and Victor Cuesta drop out. Augusto Fernandez, Javier Mascherano and Ever Banega, the midfield three. And his stage, his time, Lionel Messi's first start of Copa America Centenario. Nicolas Gaitán again covers for the injured Angel Di Maria. Posing for pictures before the off. Well, tonight's officials are led by the man from Mexico, Roberto Garcia, tonight's match referee at Gillette Stadium. Assistants Jose Camargo and Alberto Morin, fourth official Ricardo Montero of Costa Rica. Venezuela goalkeeper Dani Hernandez plays in Spain's second tier with Tenerife, and right back Alexander Gonzalez again plays in place of Roberto Rosales. Oswaldo Vizcarondo back in. Archimedes Figuera returns from suspension alongside captain Tomas Rincon. The front two, Salomon Rondon paired with Joseph Martinez. Orthodox, old school 4-4-2, the formation for the Vino Tinto. Eric Lamela, Sergio Aguero, Ezequiel Lavezzi. That is some bench, some plan B for Argentina if things don't go to plan tonight. Well, Venezuela in their burgundy, the Vino Tinto. It's just the nation's third ever Copa America quarterfinal. Their best finish in Argentina 5 years ago when they finished in fourth position. Can they reach a second ever semi at the expense of the 14-time champions of the Copa America? Tall order, big ask. It is Venezuela who start, the team ranked as the world's number 77. And here is Salomon Rondon with an early touch for them into Joseph Martinez. First touch, as the cheers tell you, for Lionel Messi as a starter at Copa America Centenario. Should mention too, one late Venezuela team change with Jose Manuel Cejas coming in place of Adalberto Peñaranda. Maybe an injury in the pre-match kick-in for the teenager. First touch here for Sergio Romero in the Argentina goal. Their most capped goalkeeper of all time, the man from England's Manchester United. Knocked on here by Rojo. And the chase is Nicolas Gaitán. Watched there by Wilker Angel. There is Tata Martino, the coach of Argentina. High ball in to test Dani Hernandez, and a good, safe, secure first claim here for the Venezuelan goalkeeper. Towards Rondon, met though by Nicolas Otamendi. Rojo. In the centre, Higuain is the obvious target here for Argentina. There could be a shot on here too. This is a fine run, and here is Lionel Messi. Messi, expectation here as he goes on. How far can he go? Messi's cross here, but well grabbed by Dani Hernandez. Got there that sense from the crowd that when Messi gets the ball, they expect things to happen, and here they so nearly did. Twists and turns, but the cross in the end a fraction too high from Lionel Messi. Again, the good work from Dani Hernandez in the Venezuela goal. This is Gabriel Mercado. Messi in the mood, here he goes. Faced up by Felcha. Messi, Mascherano. Otamendi. Now Funes Mori. Wide to find Rojo. Towards Gaitán, but Angel alert and aware. Already you can see the game's pattern here with Argentina pushing and probing with every Venezuelan player back behind the ball. Gaitán's cross. It drops here for Lionel Messi. Control sensational. It's Lionel Messi here for Argentina, who looks to be sharp. Any doubts about his fitness in the first 3 minutes dispelled totally. Already shimmering brightly on this glorious Massachusetts evening. Not far off the mark. The night where he could, with two goals, become the nation's top scorer ever in full internationals. Starts on 53. Gabriel Batistuta has 54 in full internationals. This is Salomon Rondon, met by Mascherano here. This is Cejas. Felcha towards Higuain though for Argentina. And then Cejas will get a yellow card here for the challenge on Mascherano. Luis Manuel Cejas now, should they reach a semi-final, would miss it with suspension. There's his second yellow of this competition, and the card's wiped after this game, so that will count, and we'll see him if they do reach a semi-final. He can't play in it. Late here from Cejas. It was, of course, a late inclusion in the team. Otamendi here. This is Mercado. Ball just runs away, though, from Gabriel Mercado. Argentina have certainly, at the moment, Venezuela where they want them, pushed back in their own half. Rolf Felcha, though, here towards Salomon Rondon. We've got the winner against Uruguay. This is Archimedes Figuera in now to the captain, Tomas Rincon, for Venezuela. Josef Martinez in the middle here with Rondon, if they can find him. This is Cejas, meanwhile, for Venezuela. Breaks here for Figuera. He missed the last game with Mexico with a two yellow card suspension. Break here towards Martinez. Well read though by Ramiro Funes Mori. 15 is Alejandro Guerra for Venezuela. Cejas on that early yellow card tightrope, that early booking, which means he now will play 85 minutes or so with one over his shoulder. Nicolas Otamendi of England's Manchester City. Funes Mori. Otamendi. For now, Messi on this right-hand side, hugging the touchline. It's Mercado here. Now Messi. Messi teasing Martinez here. Trademark balance, and then taken down by Figuera. Referee wants words here. Venezuela already physical, and that is a final warning, I think, here for Archimedes Figuera. Maybe even a card coming here from the referee for Mexico. Yes, he does normally get some pretty rough treatment from whoever he's playing against. That is a heavy one from Figuera. No further censure. Funes Mori here to look for Mercado's run. There is the right fullback, Gabriel Machado for Argentina. Augusto Fernandez. Funes Mori. Funes Mori's ball driven out here towards Messi. Messi's cross here towards Higuain with a chance! Inside 8 minutes, Higuain has Argentina in front. Made by Messi, of course. And Higuain sweeps the ball home for the Albiceleste. It is the perfect start to this quarter-final for them. Gonzalo Higuain on the score sheet. Argentina 1, Venezuela 0. Delicious service, as it always is from Lionel Messi. The captain provider for Gonzalo Higuain. Argentina haven't taken long to find their groove and find their rhythm and find their first goal. Made by Messi and plundered by Gonzalo Higuain. Excellent finish. It has been a strong start, underlined now by the opening goal for Argentina, scored by Higuain. But here come Venezuela here, the ball towards Martinez, and it's going to be a corner here. The game's first corner, a Venezuela corner. Already their 11th goal of Copa America Centenario 2 for Argentina. Higuain's finish. Where now, Venezuela? Corner taken by Luis Manuel Cejas. Messi. Figuera again caught him. Figuera, who was warned, what, a minute or so ago too, for a similar challenge. Can't be too far here from a yellow card, can he? Twice now on Messi. Romero Funes Mori. Given away here to Cejas. Now Rolf Felcher. Rondon. Mentioned their fairly lowly ranking of 77, Venezuela. They have already beaten this Copa America Centenario. Uruguay ranked 9 and held Mexico ranked 16. They have shown they can perform against the teams with higher, more lofty rankings. Mascherano has been dispossessed. But that record against Argentina is not a good one. One win, 19 defeats, never a draw. Towards Higuain. And defender Angel in trouble. Here's Augusto Fernandez. Lionel Messi's gone for the spectacular chip, and he's got it wrong this time. Well, Dani Hernandez here, the goalkeeper, was uncertain. And Argentina nearly profit from that uncertainty and hesitation from the Tenerife goalkeeper. Ball clipped in here into that awkward no-man's land, and Dani Hernandez and Wilker Angel got in a muddle. Wouldn't quite fall for Messi kindly, but the improvised shot drifts wide of Venezuela's goal. Rondon. Good work here. Right for Cejas. Martinez. Josef Martinez here. Return pass here for Martinez, and well defended there by Argentina. And Ramiro Funes Mori. Venezuela's first real threat there on the Argentina goal. Good defensive play here from Argentina. Ball sent in towards Rondon! Open game, which bodes well for the contest here with what, just over 12 minutes gone in Foxborough. The ground which saw only a few days ago Brazil dumped out here at the hands of Peru. Uruguay already long gone too, the most successful nation ever in Copa America history. Is there to be maybe a surprise name on the trophy? Or will a team like Argentina, a traditional big gun in South America, be the team to win this special running of the Copa America in the USA? Josef Martinez. Now Augusto Fernandez. Fernandez. Higuain. It breaks Argentina's way here. This is Tomas Rincon, who was named the best player in the Copa America in Argentina in 2011 when the Vino Tinto went on to reach the semi-final. Playing now in Italy with Genoa after a good spell with Hamburger SV in the Bundesliga. Tata Martino will know, I'm sure, that Argentina's record of being runners-up in recent competitions is one which has begun to rankle since their last success in winning the Copa America in 1993. They've reached and lost some six major finals. Augusto Fernandez. Higuain. Fernandez caught off the ball here late. That could be at least a free kick and maybe another card here dished out. It's Fernandez, the player brought down for Argentina. Oswaldo Vizcarondo, the guilty party. One of their centre-backs in that historic win over Argentina in World Cup qualifying 5 years ago. On the day when his defensive cohort that day, Fernando Amore Bieta, scored that landmark winning goal for Venezuela against Argentina for the first time. Eva Benega and Lionel Messi on this free kick to plot and scheme here for Argentina. Messi's made one. There's a line of five to find here too in those iconic white and blue striped shirts. The cross in for Argentina. Away by Rolf Felcher. Benega, Messi. Teases Felcher and then gives the ball away, but was he caught by Cejas? Referee, let's play go on this time. Martinez in for Salomon Rondon. Rondon, a real powerhouse of a central forward. Venezuela free kick here against Augusto Fernandez. Cejas caught by the player from Spain's Atletico Madrid. Same for a second time there by Diego Simeone after playing with him at River Plate as well back in Argentina. And a set piece for Venezuela. You see it early on, they're having to chase the game. Knockout football, of course, now in the quarterfinals of Copa America Centenario. No second chances. Alejandro Guerra on the free kick for Venezuela. Set piece in by Guerra. Helped on towards Rondon. Offside against Salomon Rondon. 9 goals his first English season with West Bromwich Albion in the Premier League. Winning goal here in the second group game against Argentina for Rafael Dudamel's team. Dudamel's 7th game in charge after the unhappy spell of Noel San Vicente. Just one loss in Dudamel's first 6. is Nicolas Otamendi for Argentina. In the semi-finals, the USA waiting, by the way, in Houston, Texas. This is Higuain. Now Messi. Messi comes inside of Martinez. Now towards Marcus Rojo. Rojo's pulled back here towards Eva Banega. And the stadium still filling. Eva Banega, Marcus Rojo. This is Alexander Gonzalez playing it right back in place of Roberto Rosales for the second successive game in Copa America Centenario. Here goes Rondon. Otamendi covers and does well for Argentina. Offside the decision here against Marcos Rojo. Won the English FA Cup in May with Manchester United. Close call, but maybe just about the right call by the referee's assistant from Mexico. It's Tuesday's semi-final against the USA in Houston. That's the prize on offer here for these two nations. Augusto Fernandez towards Higuain. Mirror here is the first choice for his country, but not for his club. Didn't play a single league game in England after the end of August for Manchester United. Last first team club game came back in the Europa League in February against the Danes of Midtjylland. Luis Manuel Cejas of Venezuela. Felcia. Cejas. Well, Cejas again has got the decision here. He's a fairly abrasive player. Yet to really fashion a clear chance, are they, Venezuela, in this one? A couple of 1-0 wins in the initial phase over Jamaica and Uruguay, and then that draw with Mexico in the group decider to see who won Group C. Argentina, no such worries, as they won their Group D with 3 wins from 3 after beating Chile, the team who beat them in the final on penalties in Santiago a year ago, and then regulation wins really over Panama 5-0 and Bolivia 3-0. Dudamel has done well so far in charge of Venezuela. The former goalkeeper for them scored a goal from his position as goalkeeper in a World Cup qualifier 20 years back when he scored a free kick in a 5-2 defeat to Argentina. It was no surprise his only goal in international football. Augusto Fernandez here for Javier Mascherano. Now Gabriel Mercado. Messi. Messi works the ball wide here now to involve Banega. Lionel Messi's gone down here, referee says the ball was taken, not the man. Referee was well placed there, just behind play wasn't Roberto Garcia. Looked, I must say, on first viewing in real time, a really compelling case for a penalty here for all the Argentinians. Messi sent sprawling. Tata Martino is impassive. Let's have a look at this. Figuera on Messi. Well, he's got nothing of the ball and plenty of Messi. That looks a very clear-cut decision to me for a penalty. And look where the referee is too. How has he not seen that? Well, Messi will feel he should have had a penalty, not to be. Otamendi, that's a great ball in here. And the ball put back. Higuain again with the shots. Blocked again. Wouldn't quite fall there for Banega. Rincon runs into trouble, into traffic. Higuain. Referee decides this time it is going to be a free kick Argentina's way. After Banega, the player this time who was sent crashing to the turf. Oh, Figuera with the block. And the foul here on Eva Banega. Well, Dudamel's team on the back foot here. That goal from Higuain early on. Argentina still pushing, pressing for a second here. As we are now just beyond the first half's midway point. Argentina 1, Venezuela 0. As Lionel Messi plots and schemes and conspires here for the world's number one ranked team, the world's top ranked player. This is Lionel Messi. Fairly simple catch for Dani Hernandez this time. Target here is Salomon Rondon for Venezuela. Rolf Felcher. Josef Martinez. Banega here strong, he's escaped the challenge too. Higuain. Higuain's pass out here to involve Gaetan. Gaetan pulls back, but no one there for Argentina. Funes Mori. Gonzalez here for Guerra. Rincon. Luis Manuel Cejas. Where's Cejas going? Cejas finds Salomon Rondon here. Rondon with the shot. Mascherano closes in and blocks it away to safety. It is a really open, watchable game this at the moment. On the counter, Venezuela mean business. Alexander Gonzalez here with a throw-in for the Venezuelans. Towards Rondon. Good layup too from Rondon, deflected shot, it might break towards Martinez, he appeals for the penalty. That was, I think, a fairly ambitious appeal. Now Vizca Rondo. Towards Gonzalez here. Nicolas Gaetan. Gaetan sprints away here, rides one challenge. Eva Banega, Messi. Banega again, Higuain, Augusto Fernandez, Higuain, Rojo, still retained here by Argentina as Venezuela's players all have to funnel back into their defensive stations. Augusto Fernandez. Mercado. Hello. Martinez. Figuera. Alexander Gonzalez with room to push on maybe from right back. Thomas Rincon. Cejas. Late challenge here by Nicolas Gaetan. Now he, if they do qualify, will miss the semi-final for Argentina. Gaetan has his name taken for the second time in this Copa America Centenario. Booked as well, Gaetan in the game with Panama. Well, certainly a rather frustrating lashing out there, wasn't it, from Gaetan? And as I say, he now will serve a one-match ban for the semi, if and when they get there. Alexander Gonzalez here. Gonzalez. Alejandro Guerra. Rincon. Fernandez away for Argentina. Picked up here though by Archimedes Figuera for Venezuela. Oh, the back pass short. It's Higuain in here, around Hernandez to bag his second goal, and that's a gift. Argentina 2, Venezuela 0. It comes absolutely gift-wrapped here for Gonzalo Higuain. He will never score a more simple international goal. Argentina have a two-goal lead here, one they have raced into. And the Napoli man with a brace, but this one was absolutely gift-wrapped. Goals do not come any more simple. One of the game's greatest predators does not need invitations as simple as that. Argentina have 1 foot now in Houston firmly, and a semi-final showdown with the host nation here, the United States. 2-0. Felcher dispossessed by Higuain. Augusto Fernandez, Messi. Messi, magic man. Martinez battling away here with the grounded Mercado. Before the half-hour mark here, it's a two-goal position of real comfort for Argentina. As I say, in the Copa down the years, 4 prime meetings. Never less than a 3-goal winning margin for Argentina. Closest running was 91, a 3-0 victory. Before that, in 1975, there was a 5-1 and 11-0 too, which remains Venezuela's biggest defeat. And back in Venezuela's debut year, 1967, another 5-1 defeat at the hands of Argentina. By the way, hat-trick scored in 3 of the 4 meetings previously, so Higuain could be another to add to his name to that hat-trick Hall of Fame in Argentina games in the Copa against Venezuela. Messi's free kick. Benega towards Rojo. Just though is Alejandro Guerra for Venezuela. Funes Mori. Mascherano. Mascherano's pass here for Augusto Fernandez, work wide here again for Rojo. Messi is there too, available. Have they seen Messi's run? Nicolas Otamendi for Argentina. At the moment, they're on easy street. Otamendi, and Messi involves himself in play. Otamendi, Mercado here for Argentina. Towards Augusto Fernandez. Teams meet again, by the way, in September's World Cup qualifiers. Venezuela just 1 point from their 6 on the road to Russia so far. Already, after 6 games, are some 10 points adrift of Argentina. Dudamel has yet to have a qualifier in charge. Came in April after the last 2 matches in the qualifiers. Martinez hooked in, though the ball did go beyond the line before that cross was sent in for Venezuela. Well, a win here would be Argentina's 8th win in succession. He's the goals. Messi made the first for Higuain. Excellent finish. As cool and calm as you like. Two for Higuain. Argentina on course for a semi-final in Copa America Centenario 2016. The win here would be their eighth in succession. The national record, by the way, is 9 wins in a row. That was set back way back in 1941 and 1942. Funes Mori, Mascherano. Argentina too are now somewhat, this will be 14 games in the Copa America in 90 minutes unbeaten. Before this one there, last two quarterfinals went to penalties. This one I don't think will go that far the way it's begun. Barring a remarkable Venezuela fight back. They have failed to score in 13 of their previous 20 versus Argentina. Just 10 goals ever for Venezuela against the Albi Celeste. Rojo. Ramiro Funes Mori. Mascherano, Figuera hassling him, it's going to break here for Rondon. Rondon with a great save drawn there from Romero. Venezuela's first strike on goal, and Argentina's underused goalkeeper so far tonight. Makes a fine save to keep out Salomon Rondon here. This is by a long way the best from Venezuela so far tonight. This was a chance of a way back in to this quarterfinal tie. That was a chance to get back into it. It remains though 2-0 Argentina. Fine save. Half time is now what, 10 minutes away in Foxborough. Vizcarondo, Cejas, Rondon, Martinez, Rondon. Nicolas Gaitán for Argentina. Well, Gaitán's just earned himself a move away from Benfica to join in Spain Atletico Madrid for next season. Won the league in the last three campaigns in Portugal with Benfica. A couple of League and Cup doubles, or League and League Cup doubles in the last two seasons for him. But a 2-0 lead here for Argentina, but they will feel, I'm sure, Venezuela. That second goal was for them so avoidable. Maybe just caught there by Wilker Angel. Benega, Mascherano, Rojo, Gaitán. Dudamel, the coach of Venezuela, felt that the winners here would win the trophy. This is assessment from the pre-match press call a couple of days ago. Cejas saw the ball given away again here. Here's Higuain towards Benega. Rojo's header drops it to Rolf Felcher. On the chase here, Josef Martinez. Felcher. Messi. Messi for Higuain. Now Thomas Rincon for Venezuela. They need a goal back before half-time, you feel, here. A base camp, a platform to build from in the second half. It's Rondon. No foul given. And Marcos Rojo for Argentina. The World Cup runners-up of two summers ago in Brazil. Last major trophy, Copa America 1993, which for a nation of their footballing stature is many lifetimes. Angel, Rondon, Certainly Uruguay have won this title more than Argentina. Gaitán up against Angel here, and that's going to be given Venezuela's way. Venezuela, a nation who've really been one of the minnows of South America, certainly. But they've come on leaps and bounds in the last, well, 15 or 20 years or so, the period they've called the Auge Vino Tinto, the rise of the Burgundy. Great workers coach from first Richard Páez and then Cesar Farias. Another fell away, though, under El San Vicente for a while, but one or two better signs under the new coach, the current coach, Rafael Dudamel. Any nation from the region who've never reached a FIFA World Cup. Rondon. Now Josef Martinez. That will be a corner for Venezuela. Martinez based with Italy's Torino. After a spell with Young Boys of Bern in the Swiss Super League. 3 goals in Serie A last season for Torino. Guerra and Cejas on this corner for Venezuela. In by Cejas towards Rondon with a header, and he's hit the post. Salomon Rondon with a brutal connection, and so unlucky for Venezuela. So unfortunate. It is, though, a good response by Venezuela, this. Rondon off the post. It stays 2-0, but here is Figuera. Felcher. Towards on the volley there, Alejandro Guerra. Well, Rondon here was really unlucky. That's a terrific connection, a terrific leap and header here from Rondon. Back off the post, and Venezuela were that close to a way back into this. A real scare for Argentina. Gonzalez. Now Nicolas Gaitán breaks though for Thomas Rincón for Venezuela. Turns well away from Gaitán. Gonzalez. Mascherano always there, always efficient. Half time now, 5 minutes distance. Argentina 2. 2 goals from Higuain to nil up on Venezuela. Rondon. Full back here towards Rolf Felcher. And Felcher's shot is deflected. Oh, and what a save by Romero. Outstanding goalkeeping here. The deflection made his job so much more difficult. But how has he responded here? Excellent save. That is a magnificent piece of goalkeeping, it really is. Rolf Felcher denied. One of the saves of this Copa America Centenario for sure. Venezuela corner towards Angel. Here's Vizcarondo. Martinez taken down! Oh, no penalty! Play goes on here with Venezuela. The cross towards Rondon. Angel's in there as well. Here is Rondon. By far their best bet of the game here, Venezuela. Rolf Felcher. Still two down here, but you can't fault the effort here from Venezuela. Figuera, robbed by Messi. Rincón. Rincón for Rondon. Forced wide by the pass, though, rather. In towards Martinez. Keeper comes to meet him. Penalty given here for Venezuela. Romero takes down Martinez. And that hands before half-time Venezuela a great chance to get back into this quarter-final. This has been their best spell of the half by a long way, Venezuela. And now, from the spot, can they find a way back in to this game against Argentina? Caught him. Romero on Martinez. Venezuela have a penalty and a chance before half-time here through Luis Manuel Cejas for a lifeline, a base camp, a way back into Copa America Centenario. Cejas before kickoff, a late name on the team sheet. He wasn't due to start this game. Now he can maybe start Venezuela's fight back in the contest. Half-time, 2 minutes distant. Luis Manuel Cejas for Venezuela. Cejas, oh, he tried to be clever. Result anything but. Luis Manuel Cejas has fluffed it. How often do we see a goalkeeper commit early, and those Panenka penalties, when they go in, look fabulous. When they don't, the player looks a mug. Romero save, and Cejas is the most red-faced man in the stadium. Martinez. Martinez towards Rondon. This is Nicolas Otamendi. Venega, Nicolas Gaitán here towards Higuaín, and Vizcarondo covering for Venezuela. Corner prevented. The last minute of the first half's regulation time. It's been a really eventful game, this one to really enjoy and savour, but Venezuela will, I'm sure, look back on that missed penalty. What might have been. Venega here for Mascherano. Otamendi. Augusto Fernandez. That's a free kick. Luis Manuel Cejas, the player who, with that penalty, saw the chance, did not take the chance. Oh, too casual. So the whistle ends the first half. Meanwhile, this is the missed penalty from Cejas, and he will now do Demel. That was their chance for way back into this quarterfinal. As it is, as the players depart, it's been the Higuaín show so far. A brace of goals for the Napoli striker in this Copa America quarterfinal, as Argentina in the driving seat at the break. He scored twice, Messi made the first, but Argentina have had a let off, that missed penalty before the break. So Venezuela toss away their chance. Half time at this Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. Argentina 2, Venezuela 0 at half time. Argentina leave the field with this position of dominance, but Venezuela missed chances. How expensive will they prove for the Vino Tinto? Cejas their head bowed as he walks off the field. He's the man who missed the penalty, he's the man who fluffed his lines, and he's the man who saved it.
Clutch. Snipers, game changers, finishers. Charting a Stanley Cup march, one goal at a time. Whether it's glove side high, stick side low, or five hole. Slap shot, snapshot, or wrister. It doesn't matter. They'll find the twine. And the playoffs is their time.
Right now, there's an amazing deal on super reliable BT broadband. Join today and get a massive 50% off. It's £5.50 or visit bt.com/deals.
Airwaves in a bottle. So you can always keep that kick handy.
Plenty of replica Messi shirts in the crowd too. Well, Venezuela, not only have scored 10 goals against Argentina, have to score at least two more here to save this quarter-final. That's how difficult their task is in the second half coming up. Has the damage been done in that first half by Gonzalo Higuain for Argentina? The Napoli man with those two goals. Only became last season the high scorer ever in an Italian Serie A season with 36 in 35 games in the Italian top division. And his two goals here at halftime have Argentina in the driving seat, on course to reach the semis and face the USA in Houston on Tuesday. Well, this is by far the biggest crowd so far at this stadium in Foxborough. We are to the south of Boston. Boston is the nearest major city in this region. The stadium did host the World Cup in 94 too. This was where Argentina beat Greece 4-0 and Gabriel Batistuta scored a hat-trick. And he that tonight could see his record as top scorer snatched away if in the second half Lionel Messi can score twice for Argentina. This will be, it seems, five wins from five over Venezuela at the Copa America for Argentina. Semi-final in Houston against the USA as they try to win their first major trophy, Argentina, since 1993. But how big a turning point in this game was that missed penalty by Luis Manuel Cejas for Venezuela just before half-time. Big moment. The kind of moment which changes and decides football matches of the magnitude of this one. Copa America quarterfinal in Foxborough. Argentina with Lionel Messi a starter against Venezuela, and Messi began early. His assist for Gonzalo Higuain, the first goal swept home by the Napoli striker, but made by Messi, the peerless Messi. And this was a delivery of the highest order and a finish worthy of it. Higuain had Argentina off and running. Just one defeat in 20 against Venezuela, 19 wins, one loss on their way against them here in their 21st meeting. And then a gift for Higuain, the ball straight to him. He will never score a more simple goal in international football than that. He has a brace. The wayward pass, picked off, punished. Higuain deadly. A gift, a second goal, and maybe a semi-final place gift wrapped here for the RB Celeste. But then came the rally after Mascherano was caught out here. Salomon Rondon forced a fine save from Sergio Romero here in the Argentina goal. I see it was to have a busy end of the half, the goalkeeper. Figuera hassling the mistake from Mascherano, and Rondon of West Bromwich Albion denied here by the goalkeeper. Fine save. Then Rondon again, a header from a corner off the post. Venezuela knocking as the half wore on, louder and louder still, but could not find a way through, could they? Rondon unlucky. More chances came for Venezuela. Rondon with that header off the woodwork. And then a penalty. Romero chopping down Martinez. Referee from Mexico, Roberto Garcia, said penalty Venezuela. Luis Manuel Cejas with a Panenka. When they go in, they're great. When they don't, you look a mug. Is that Venezuela's chance of a comeback gone? Higuain's brace. Half-time, Argentina 2, Venezuela 0.
Colombia and Peru met in the second quarterfinal of the Copa America Centenario. History was on Peru's side going into last night's game as the nations met in the 2011 Copa America and last year's group stages, but Colombia failed to win on both occasions. The opening chance of the game fell to Los Cafeteros as Carlos Bacca dribbled into the area and forced a save out of Galese.
Here's Bacca. It's Carlos Bacca. Can he go all the way? Pushed behind by Galese. Carlos Bacca with a little run forward here.
James Rodriguez found some space at the edge of the box as his right-footed shot rattled off the post, and Bacca was unable to put away the follow-up.
Off the post! And the rebound is wide. James Rodriguez so close to the opening goal of the night, and I'm sure there were thousands inside this stadium who thought that was in.
There was a bit of controversy early in the second half after Carlos Bacca was clearly taken down off the ball by Peruvian defender Tapia.
Arias with the ball into the middle towards Bacca. Was he blocked? He thought so. Colombian supporters thought so. The Argentine referee said he was not, and Tapia again is on a heap on the floor. Really has been in the wars tonight. Well, challenge came in from Tapia on Bacca. There it is. Referee says no penalty.
The last chance of the game fell to Peru's Ramos, who smashed a header on target. But Ospina made a fingertip tournament-saving stop.
Plenty of heads go up for it. Oh, what a save from Ospina. Absolutely outstanding. To deny Peru a late stoppage time winner. As the header comes in from Christian Ramos, it was dipping in just under the bar until Ospina's intervention. And that's it. We will go to penalties to determine which of Peru and Colombia go through to the semi-finals at the Copa America Centenario. 90 minutes of fervent action, but no goals. James Rodriguez scores. Rudias blasted in. Cool as you like. Well, that was just as good as Cuadrado's. Ooh, goodness me. If the goalkeeper hadn't moved, he'd have been able to make the easiest of saves. Trauco. Saved by Ospina. Advantage Colombia. And it's successfully converted to keep Peru's dreams alive. Otherwise, Colombia will go through to the semi-finals. Cueva up against Ospina, who saved the last penalty kick. Oh, it's been missed! Colombia go through!
So David Ospina was Colombia's hero in the end, as Los Cafeteros progressed to their first Copa America semi-final since 2004, after beating the Peruvians 4-2 on penalties. Now let's take a look at our favourite goals of the tournament so far.
It comes away fortuitously for Paraguay here! What a goal! It's an absolute corker! A rasping shot into the net from Victor Ayala.
Felipe Coutinho. Coutinho! Oh, that's how you bag a hat-trick! Marvellous goal!
Campos for goal. Smedberg Delenser to maybe cross. Yasmani Campos has gone for goal! Oh, that is magnificent! Yasmani Campos for Bolivia. It is a thunderbolter.
Wouldn't this be a crowd pleaser if Messi were to curl one in from here? Messi! Oh my word! It was well worth the wait, wasn't it? Lionel Messi has just brought Soldier Field to its feet.
Sonoma Speedway is like no other NASCAR track. Tricky, treacherous, and terrifying.
Are you kidding me?
Kyle Busch wins at Sonoma.
Don't miss out on the excitement next Sunday on Premier Sports HD.
Enjoy the game.
Will do.
I'm back.
Feel the excitement with 10bet. Join now with up to £200 first deposit bonus.
When it comes to your dry skin or eczema, trust E45 cream. Its clinically proven formula creates an effective barrier that helps repair and protect even eczema-prone skin. E45, dry skin experts for more than 60 years. And now, try our new fast-absorbing E45 24-hour moisturising sprays.
Right now, there's an amazing deal on super reliable BT broadband. Join today or visit bt.com/deals.
Hit the ball, be done with it, leather it. Is that Venezuela's chance gone? We shall see. Good crowd of, and imagine the thick end of 60,000 tonight in this stadium to see this game. And they've come to see that man, Lionel Messi. He made the first goal. Not his dazzling best maybe tonight, but Argentina so far have been simply too good for Venezuela. That's 12 goals now in 3.5 games in this Copa America Centenario for Argentina. They are the top scorers here by some distance. In the group stage, they put 2 past Chile, 5 past Panama, and 3 against Bolivia. And already 2 and counting against Venezuela. Well, we all love Messi, we all do, but can Venezuela find a way to stop him and Argentina from adding to their tally in the second half? Venezuela just 1 win ever against Argentina. That is how difficult their task in this second half is. Number 13 there, Luis Manuel Cejas, wasn't due to start this game. A pre-match knock to Adalberto Peñarandamenti was in, and it was he who took the penalty. 2 goals in 66 prior internationals. Could not find number 3. Had he done so, different game, second half 2-1, not a 2-0. It is a gulf they have to try and plug in this second 45 minutes. Coach Rafael Dudamel has had his say, had his chance to impart his wisdom. Do Argentina stick or do they twist and try and find more goals to underline their place in this Copa America Centenario's semi-finals? This would be Dudamel's first competitive defeat as Venezuela head coach. I would say too, if they can come back, it'll be maybe their best comeback of all time, Venezuela. So Argentina retake the stage. A position of comfort, 2-0 up. One half away from the last four of Copa America Centenario. The nation without a major trophy now for 23 years. Two Gonzalo Higuain goals, the difference. In three of the previous four meetings at Copa Americas between these two nations, there's been an Argentina hat-trick. There'll be a fourth in five. Previous trebles against Venezuela for Argentina by in 1967 Luis Artime, in 1975 both Leopoldo Luque and Daniel Killer. Maybe in the second half we'll see the name of Higuain on that roll of honour. Second half is go. Argentina one half away now from the semi-finals. A 2-0 lead here over Venezuela. Venezuela have scored in their history just 10 goals against Argentina. Have to find two in the second half to save themselves in this competition. That's the bottom line for Venezuela. It is, from their position, a long, long way back from here. From the first half, both teams unchanged. Goes Guerra. That's Nicolas Gaitán for Gonzalo Higuain. Messi here for Gaitán. Nicolas Gaitán. Gaitán, how far can he go? Pulls back and no one able to make a connection. Higuain went over. Nearly a perfect second half start for Argentina here. Higuain was the intended target. Messi fed Gaitán and the ball back just too far in front of Higuain. Eva Benega, Lionel Messi, Mascherano, Mercado. That will be a throw for Venezuela. Martinez, Mascherano's pass here, work wide for Marcus Rojo. Funes Mori, Otamendi, Augusto Fernandez. Dudamel has had his chance to try and change things in the interval. Lionel Messi. This is Wilker Angel. Towards Rondon here, met by Funes Mori. Rondon escapes Otamendi here, comes to Figuera. Alexander Gonzalez. Gonzalez again here for Venezuela. He didn't play bad in that first half at all, did they, Venezuela? They had lots of chances. Hit the post, forced two outstanding saves from Romero in that first period. Missed the penalty as well, of course. Have shown signs of being able to live with Argentina. They've scored with their only two shots on goal in the game so far. I must say the save in the first half from Felche's deflected shot was of outstanding quality from this man, Sergio Romero, Argentina's most capped goalkeeper ever. Tonight he's 77 for the national team. Played more games for his nation than for his club last season. The Thomas Rincon free kick here for Venezuela. A goal will equate to belief, I'm sure, for the Vino Tinto. Away by Otamendi, comes here to Arquimedes Figuera. Felcher. Joseph Martinez. Rincon. That's a foul. Referee sees the little tug back there in midfield. That's going to be a free kick for Venezuela. Oh, a much happier squad now. They've got Dudamel in charge. Players wrote an open letter to the nation's federation to protest at the management of the previous coach, Noel San Vicente. Player power saw him lose his job. Results have picked up big time under Dudamel. Ball clipped in here for Venezuela, and that'll be a corner too as they chase the game. By Figuera, glanced away by Javier Mascherano, the nation's second most capped of all time for Argentina. Only Javier Zanetti's won more caps for Argentina. Header on, over the bar from Joseph Martinez. Very sharp striker. It is a good pairing too, he and Rondon, little and large. Give Dudamel different options, don't they, the two strikers. Both scored winning goals in the first phase of matches. Against Jamaica it was Martinez, against Uruguay it was the turn of Salomon Rondon. Alejandro Guerra. Rincon. Guerra. Rondon. Rondon's cross, and Guerra comes here for Gonzalez, but now the break is on for Argentina. Messi on halfway. Messi being wrestled, but he's escaped one, and then Figuera caught him. Arquimedes Figuera gets a yellow card. Well, it's shown towards Angel. I think the foul there was by the number five, Figuera. Messi sent sprawling here. Showed the card towards Wilker Angel, but I thought the initial foul was by the number five, Arquimedes Figuera. That's the first challenge there by Rincon. He escapes that one, and then Figuera comes back at him, and there's the foul by Figuera. But the yellow card was shown towards the number two, Wilker Angel. It may be a case there of the referee getting mistaken identity on the actual man who made the foul. Here's Messi. Mascherano's pass. Argentina's first front foot spell of this second half as they look for a third goal. Surely a third goal will be a game-clinching goal for Tata Martino's side in this quarter-final. Argentina's 12th successive appearance when they've been in the Copa in the knockout phases. Free kick taken here by Eva Benega. He'll be bound for Inter Milan when this Copa is done. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to find here in or around the box for Eva Benega for Argentina. Benega's free kick away by Martinez. Alexander Gonzalez. Oh, Messi's picked his pocket here for Argentina. A play call back. Maybe a handball, was it? Oh, Martino and Argentina are confused here why that free kick was given against Messi. I must say, I'm fairly bamboozled as well by it. Here is Juanpi coming on, Juan Pablo Añor, known as Juanpi at his club Malaga in Spain. On for Cejas. Figueroa's lost out here. Augusto Fernandez for Lionel Messi. Messi sets off here. Messi. Messi again, fed by Benega. Mercado's cross, Augusto Fernandez! And it stays 2-0. Augusto Fernandez there with Argentina's first real second-half chance. A move which was begun by Messi, but not quite finished by Fernandez. Rondon, Martinez. Martinez for Rondon, comes back here towards Rincon. It'll be picked up by Venezuela and Figueroa. Augusto Fernandez, tenacious. Gaitán for Higuaín. Messi. Well, Messi again chopped down, this time by Rolf Felcher. He's getting some real roughhouse treatment, isn't he, Messi? Well, the quick free kick here is found Marcos Rojo. Rincon. Ahead Rondon. Good run made here by Rolf Felcher. Been a stop-start second half so far, hasn't it? Shirt pull there by Felcher on Nicolas Otamendi. Neva Benega. Mascherano. Just get the impression there's an Argentinian head of steam building here. Looking for that third goal to really dot the I's and cross the T's of their qualification for the semi-final. Benega. Messi. Messi so fleet of foot. Offside here, flag up against Josef Martinez. Martinez with five goals in 30 prior caps, the man who won the penalty, and there you see way, way beyond the Argentina defensive line. Here is Juan Pablo Añor, or Juanpi, as he's known at his club Malaga, for the second half. Rondon. Can they find the energy they showed late in the first half to try and find a way back into this Venezuela? Rondon has looked likely. Figueroa. Felcher. It's a long ball towards Alexander Gonzalez. Nicolas Gaitán. Of course, still no Angel Di Maria, injured at the moment for Argentina. There is his stand-in, Gaitán. Not a bad standing, is he? Now Higuain. That's a glorious ball to switch the play wide here for Augusto Fernandez. Mercado. Fernandez. Eva Benega. Benega's ball clipped in, but there is Dani Hernandez to come and claim. much of the keeper's career played in the Spanish lower divisions. Wilker Angel confirmed as the earlier booking, but I'm pretty sure the referee got the wrong man. It was clearly a foul by Figuera, but a card shown to Wilker Angel. Mascherano here. Now Benega. Nearing the hour mark in this quarter-final tie of Copa America Centenario 2016 in the USA. That's a bonus Copa, next one in Brazil in 2019. Higuain here for Lionel Messi. Messi on for Nicolas Gaetan for Messi! And Lionel Messi has now tied the record for full international goals for Argentina with Gabriel Batistuta. Number 54 from Lionel Messi. And that does dot the I's and cross the T's as they confirm their place in Copa America Centenario's semi-finals on Tuesday, where they will take on the USA. Messi's fourth goal of this Copa. He's now the tournament's top scorer. It had to be. The fans came to see this, and now they have seen it. A goal from Lionel Messi. Steered beyond Dani Hernandez, the master craftsman, doing what he does best, what he does better than anybody. Messi's goal, 3-0 Argentina. As I say, that now levels the record with Batistuta for the most full international goals for Argentina. 54. That's cap number 111 for Messi. There's Rondon. Juanpi. For Felcher. Juanpi, Wilker Angel. Angel into Juanpi. Well, they came to see Messi score. Of course he scored, he always scores. And Messi has surely now put them on their way to that semi-final. The one thing missing from his trophy cabinet is a major international title. I wonder if this Copa America is where Messi does get his hands on an international senior trophy. Guerra's corner. Hammered clear towards Nicolas Gaetan. Gaetan puts the pressure on Gonzalez. Mascherano. Otamendi. Ahead here is Augusto Fernandez. Felcher's lost out. Messi sees the chance here. And he's been taken down. Another dreadful challenge on Messi. And Figuera now is booked now. That is a yellow for him, but should that be his second? Maybe escape the earlier yellow card. Another case of mistaken identification. That was Figuera, certainly. It is a yellow card, but that for me should be his second. Lucky. Well, Messi has placed the ball, the goal, the record in his sights. One more goal, and he goes clear. Results is done. Now the interest is in Messi, maybe breaking yet another record. Whipped in by Messi. Hernandez with the punch away. Gaetan back out towards his captain, Alejandro Guerra. Benega, Mercado. Well, 13 goals in this Copa now for Argentina. 4 for Messi. Another corner here, won by Argentina. And 4 previous Copa matches with Venezuela, all won by at least a 3-goal margin. Just listen to the roar as Messi takes a corner. Corner for Messi. Hernandez hasn't got it, but has got a free kick. Well, Messi, this the goal which takes him level with Gabriel Batistuta. Batigol's record has been equaled here by Lionel Messi. His 54th full international goal for Argentina. One away from a new benchmark. They love him. The planet loves him. Behind Juanpi, this is Higuain. Messi. Cross here, sent in very long. Kept alive though by Marcus Rojo. He's the full-back, by the way. Look how far advanced he is, Marcus Rojo. They know there are more goals here in them there hills. Argentina have Eric Lamela getting ready to come on. Maybe Nicolas Gaetan's race is run. Would be a like-for-like change here. Maybe Gaetan's hamstring is gone. Now, given Di Maria is an injury doubt for the remaining matches, this could be a real issue for Argentina in that wide left position. Lamela can certainly play there and will play there now for the game's last quarter. As Nicolas Gaetan will trot away, much I'm sure to the consternation of his new club, Atletico Madrid. So Gaetan off, and here comes Eric Lamela of England's Tottenham Hotspur. Scored in the win over Bolivia in the last game of the group stage, and he comes on now for the last, what, half of this half. In Argentina, it seems, home and hosed. Juanpi. This is Rolf Felcia. Mercado battling away there with Felcia. Mascherano driven out here towards Lamela. First touch here for the Spurs winger. Involves Marcus Rojo of England's Manchester United. The English baseman, Ramiro Funes Mori of Everton. He'll go back to Texas then, where he was raised. Moved to the USA at the age of 10. Funes Mori, raised in Texas. Played for FC Dallas briefly. Houston, the destination for the semi against the USA on Tuesday for Argentina, barring the most remarkable comeback Venezuela have ever known. Figuera. Osvaldo Vizcarondo. Felcher away from Mercado here. Felcher's cross sliced away in behind for a corner for Nicolas Otamendi. It is for Venezuela a rather chastening quarterfinal. But how different had they scored their penalty in the first half at 2-0. In by Guerra. Figueras lost out. Lamela for Messi. Rolf Felcher. Alejandro Guerra. Guerra here. Into the path of Martinez, but across the cover comes Ramiro Funes Mori. Again, possession changes hands here. And the cross for Rondon! And Rondon has a goal back for Venezuela. It is a long way back. But with 20 minutes left to play, is that Venezuela back in business? Rondon's second goal of Copa America Centenario. Fine climb, marvellous header. Venezuela on the board at 3-1 behind. Off the post and in this time. Unlike his first half denial by the goal's frame. Rondon's 18th goal for his country. 3-1. Ball pulled back here for Messi. Shot on here and the ball has crept across the line. 4-1. And that glimmer is now put out by Eric Lamela. Hopes of the fight back extinguished. Almost Lamela's first touch since coming on, as he makes it 4-1 for Argentina. Messi again had a big hand there, turning provider. Eric Lamela, scuffed shot. Goalkeeper Hernandez, maybe wrong-footed here. Could not get down quickly enough. Argentina 4, Venezuela 1. Lamela with his second goal in two matches. Rondon. Now Juanpi. Martinez. Eva Benega. Mercado towards Augusto Fernandez. Mascherano. Lamela. Rojo. Lamela. Otamendi, Mercado, here's Benega, meanwhile, Venezuela beware, because waiting to come on is no less than Sergio Aguero. Such is Argentina's amazing firepower, even on the bench. 17 to play, 4-1 the score for Argentina. Here is Martinez, looks for the run behind of Guerra. Offside the decision. Down the years, a couple of 5-1s when these sides have met in the Copa America. 1967, 1975. Here the change we'll see coming off. The man who got the first two goals, Gonzalo Higuain, to a huge ovation around the stadium. Just listen to this. And coming on, Sergio Aguero. One of the best. 4-1 of the best. That is the strength they have on their bench, Argentina. Such a deep squad here at this Copa America Centenario. Higuain's done his job. Those first two goals, the ones which really gave the platform to secure the victory. Now it's just the margin, the manner, the style with which they booked their place in Tuesday's game with the USA. Eva Banega, Augusto Fernandez, Otamendi, Gabriel Mercado. Aguero's dummy here for Lionel Messi. It's Messi! Nearly. Nearly a special moment. Nearly an historic moment for Argentina. Not quite. It will come, I'm sure, at some point. It will. If not tonight, then maybe in the next game. But Messi is in the business of goals tonight. Either scoring or making. Juanpi shrugged aside here by Lamela. Augusto Fernandez, who's had a very efficient game in midfield today, playing in place of Lucas Biglia. Banega for Mercado. Mascherano, Messi. Marcus Rojo, Eric Lamela. Lamela, Banega, breaks back here for Messi. Relentless Argentina keep ball here. Marcus Rojo. Well, they came to see goals. They've been well rewarded so far. The crowd here of well over 60,000, I imagine, for this one. Messi and Co. always a big draw in a major quarter-final, especially so. Vizcarondo here for Rincon. Towards Rondon. Otamendi holds off the challenge well there of Salomon Rondon, who was rather late on him. And will get himself a yellow card as well. Salomon Rondon, the latest name taken by the referee from Mexico tonight. Here, a little shove on Nicolas Otamendi. He's deemed a bridge too far. Yellow card confirmed for the West Bromwich Albion striker. Dispels in both Spain and in Russia. Now in West Bromwich Albion's Premier League squad. Vizcarondo. Banega. Funes Mori here for Rojo. To Mendy. Garrett tries to play in Rondon. Mascherano's pass. Helped on here for Argentina. Messi. Ahead, Aguero's been seen here. Can he find him? Gonzalez there cuts out the ball to Aguero. But look how quick they win the ball back, even at 4-1. Messi for Aguero. Aguero here, on he goes. That's going to be given as a goal kick only here for Venezuela. 11 more minutes to, I guess, endure for the Venezuelans here. Or for Argentina to add to their already mighty tally of 14 goals in not quite four full games at Copa America Centenario. top scorers in the competition by a long way. Lamela. Agüero. More changes forthcoming. We're going to see Jonathan Del Valle coming on for Venezuela. And I think Lucas Biglia too for Argentina down there as well, number six. So Josef Martinez makes way for Jonathan Del Valle. Spent the last campaign in Turkey with Kasim Pasha. 12 caps, no goals as yet for Del Valle. As Eber Benega takes a breather, replaced by Lazio's Lucas Biglia for the last 10 minutes. So Messi will get the full 90. Romero's clearance towards Eric Lamela. Fans will get then the full deal. They'll see Messi complete the 90 minutes. Jonathan Del Valle on for Josef Martinez for Venezuela. I'm sure Jürgen Klinsmann and the USA are watching this game very intently. How do you begin to stop Argentina? It will be certainly the USA's most stern test of this Copa America Centenario so far. Alexander Gonzalez. And again, Gonzalez here works the ball wide to Juanpi. Target here is Rondon. Well, Rondon is a proper old-fashioned striker. He does thrive on those lofted crosses, doesn't he? So Lucas Biglia on for Eber Benega. Now confirmed is just shy of the 60,000 mark tonight. Some distance, the biggest crowd here at the three games in Foxborough. Juanpi, Agüero, Figuera there for Venezuela. Thomas Rincon has a problem here. Thomas Rincon of Italy's Genoa. Maybe just jarred a hamstring here as he maybe just overextended himself. It's okay to resume. Mascherano and Messi for Biglia. Biglia spreads the play here to Gabriel Mercado for Argentina. Augusto Fernandes, Lucas Biglia. Agüero. Augusto Fernandes wriggles free of a couple of challenges there, and then he's been caught by Del Valle. More to play, 7 minutes plus, maybe a token couple of added minutes as well for all the injuries and bookings and changes, of which there have been lots of changes and lots of bookings as well. Maybe an erroneous one too, with Figuera escaping an earlier caution, which would have been then met by a second and a sending off. Rondon. It's going to break it towards Juanpi. Eric Lamela. Biglia. referee here, I think, has seen that Rincon is in trouble and will be replaced here. The armband comes off, and we're going to see in his place Jose Manuel Velasquez will come on. He of the spectacular overhead kick goal in the last game with Mexico. Velasquez of Arouca, the surprise team in Portugal last season, who went on to have a terrific finish of fifth place in the Portuguese league. And Velasquez will come on for the injured captain here, Thomas Rincon. He will now focus on his fitness ahead of the new Italian season with Genoa. As Velasquez comes on to win here, cap number 19. Man has been passed on to Oswaldo Vizcarondo. Last 5 minutes of this Copa America Centenario quarter-final in Foxborough, south of Boston in Massachusetts, which has been a great host to us at this Copa America Centenario too. Lovely region of the United States. Rojo, that's Mascherano. Goes Biglia. Del Valle. Now Rolf Felcher. Guerra. Juanpi. Aguero picks the pocket here. Messi. Biglia. Again, those Albiceleste shirts, the sky blue shirts of Argentina. Sky blue and white. Retain possession, make Venezuela chase shadows. Rojo. Romero put a big save in the first half. Let's not forget those from the goalkeeper. Marcos Rojo. Eric Lamela. Lamela wide here for Argentina. Otamendi. Biglia. Here they feed Messi, faced up by Alejandro Guerra. Biglia. Lamela. Aguero. Aguero's close control. Didn't quite break back for Biglia. Here's Mascherano for Messi. Messi on here for Augusto Fernandez. A cross goal, but not into the path of an Argentina attacker. Lamela was close. And Lamela here has been penalised too for the trip on Alexander Gonzalez. Lamela, scorer of Tata Martino's team's fourth goal tonight. Are there more before we're done? Rondon, Del Valle. Rondon. Mascherano. Mascherano here. Striding away. Looks for Aguero's run. Would have been offside, I think, anyway. They already made the run, Aguero. Velasquez. Rondon's chip into the path of Del Valle. Well, time now is running out. Ricardo tenacious in the tackle here, finds Lucas Biglia. A little too short for Messi. And Lamela. Eric Lamela has done really well here. On he goes, Lamela. Finds Aguero too. Aguero takes on the shot, which Dani Hernandez is down to smother. Lamela there would not be shaken off, would not take no for an answer there, would he, for Argentina? Here is Salomon Rondon. Rondon's worked really hard for his team. He's got his goal, he's hit the post. He has been a real threat for the Venezuelans, but Argentina simply too good, I think, in the final assessment. Alexander Gonzalez here for Juanpi. Rolf Felcher. Biglia. Now Lionel Messi. Otamendi. Last minute will be, we hear two more additional. Ramiro Funes Mori. Set for a trip back to his childhood home in Texas for the semi-final. With the USA waiting now on Tuesday to lock horns with Argentina. That is a mouth-watering semi-final for sure in this Copa. Here's Aguero for Lionel Messi. Messi, Aguero. Aguero wide here for Lamela. Forced a little too wide maybe. Here is Javier Mascherano, and Javier Zanetti has more caps than he for Argentina. Aguero, Mercado,